We're going to install a roller furling on this Pearson Triton today. We're putting on a Harken Mark IV Unit Zero. And it comes with everything you need except for the head stay. Got the instructions. Comes with furling line. And all the parts you need for bushings, tools, sealant, feeder, and these are the foils, upper swivel. To start off, we're taking the old head stay down, and it's laying out here, and I've marked it with tape so that we can get the accurate length for measuring for the foils and the new head stay, which is here. And this is a new 7/16 turnbuckle, chromed bronze open body, and a 7/16 stay lock stud to assemble on the 7/32 wire. One other thing you need to buy from the Harken people is this special toggle that goes at the lower end. And then we added our own link plates and another toggle to get some height for clearance for the anchor. And I took down that head stay yesterday, the temporary one we had up there. And we've got the staysail stay holding the mast up. And otherwise you could use spinnaker jib halyards to support the mast forward. Comes with a standard foil length kit here of a short one at the bottom and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 long tubes. If you need one more, you can order an extra. But we're going to hold the two stays at the same length and measure for cutting. With the new turnbuckle two-thirds open, we line up the old head stay pin and the new one with the toggle in place, and then we can mark and cut the new stay to fit the stay lock. Instead of relying on lots of measuring according to the instruction book, I laid out all the components so that they line up. There's the starting at the clevis pin at the bottom for the stem head fitting, the old stay and the new one alongside, turnbuckle two-thirds open, and the wire is marked for cutting. I've also positioned the lower assembly so that it lines up with the pin that goes through it. And I've put the bottom foil into that lower drum assembly at the midpoint of its adjustment, and then laid all of the tubes end to end. Where it's too long to cut it a half inch below the upper swage fitting. We've cut the top foil to length, and they give you a paper template to cut out and tape on to the top where you cut it for drilling a couple of screw holes, and later we're going to put those screws in to hold this trim cap, which gets tapped in here. We've slid all the foils onto the head stay and installed the trim cap at the top. To assemble these foils together, take a connector and slide it on to the wire, and one end of these plastic wedges goes under that hook, and then the short end goes there. And that slides in. And these little plastic caps go on there. Hold that in as you slide it until the holes line up. And that center hole is for the 5200. They give you a tube and a syringe. Load that up, squeeze it in until you see some of the caulking coming out into these two holes. Then you can put a drop of the Loctite in the holes and on the threads. These two little screws they give you. Tighten those up. They gotta be snug, but don't over tighten or the threads will strip. And then repeat on this side. Then repeat for all the other foils. The bottom connector here is longer than all the others, and that goes in just above the bottom foil because you need the extra length for the sail feed here. Make sure the upper swivel is on before you assemble the lower end. We installed the sail feed fitting and ready to install the stay lock. I found I needed a little more wire at the lower end to get the stay lock fitting assembled, so I pulled off the top cap and slid the tube all the way up to the end, and that gave me several inches more wire. And after the stay lock's installed, I'll put the cap back on. I've slid this drum assembly up onto the lower tube and out of the way. And for stay lock fitting, they want you to put a washer on first, then you can slide the upper end of the stay lock, then unravel the outer strands of wires to leave the inner strand, file if needed to get this wedge to slide over there, and put that on so that the wedge is up about 3/16 of an inch exposed on the end, and then wrap these wires back around in a spiral and use this to hold them in place while you get them final set. Make sure that none fall into the slot in the wedge. Looks good. Then add a drop of multi-caulk to lubricate the threads so you don't gall the stay lock fitting. And we'll assemble it first like that, making sure that the former is in the bottom. And then we'll disassemble it after we tighten it to make sure that all the wires have bent over properly. You want to turn the lower end of the stay lock, not the upper end on the wire, so you don't want the wire to be rotating. Thank you. we look at the end to make sure that everything is even and the slot has not got a wire down stuck inside of it. And that looks good. Then we make sure that that former is seated down in there and fill the lower end up about halfway with multi-caulk to keep the salt water from forming crystals down in there. And then we'll assemble it for the final time. See, some caulking is squeezed out the top, so that will displace any salt that tries to build up in there. Now, assembling the toggle and the link plates we need to give anchor clearance. They want you to install this cross pin through the lower assembly here into the special Harkin toggle so that it is at a 90 degree to the Klebs pin that goes to the chain plate on the stem head fitting. Now they give you two sets of holes here so that you can orient it any direction depending on how many toggles and link plates you use. It could come out that you use different set of holes. We're going to hoist the furler with the spinnaker halyard. We've got the lower end of the furler just lashed loosely in place, and now we'll climb the mast to put the pin in the top. Right, we've got a halyard restrainer on the mast there, and I've hoisted up the upper swivel to see how it fits. And there's a good angle back so it can't get a halyard wrap. And it has a few inches of foil left at the top of the swivel, so it can't come off the top. Now, to get the head stay turnbuckle adjusted, we loosen these Allen heads here and pull this pin out of the bottom. Then you can pull that back and lift that lower drum assembly up out of the way. Now the turnbuckle's exposed. And they supply the furling line here. You've wrapped up on the drum, and there's the lead block. If the line tends to ride up on the bottom of the drum, then you need to move the lead up. And if it rides at the top, you need to move it down. And then we've got the stanchion blocks to run the furling line aft.